I love my shortcuts, my keyboard shortcuts. They make me happy when I've lost my zen. All I can tell you is I'm a little bit special. That's why I'm making these silly videos for you. And you, and you, and you. And welcome back to the Cuckoo Nest. So if you're still watching, today is Zen Tips number 5. And in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you my personal favorite collection of keyboard shortcuts for Sony Vegas and Movie Studio Platinum. What I found is that people that like to use shortcuts, everyone has their own little favorites. I'm always learning things off other people. And today I'm going to share you my favorites. They're all pretty simple, but I love simple. There is actually a huge range of keyboard shortcuts available, and I collated them all last year and made a free ebook. So if you subscribe to the Movie Studio Zen newsletter or join the Movie Studio Zen forum, I will automatically send you those free downloads straight away. They're well worth having a look at. So yeah, without further ado, let's jump into the program and let's get cooking. Okay, so I was just telling you about the free keyboard shortcut guides that I've created. There's one for Sony Vegas Pro, this is what it looks like. And there's one for Movie Studio Platinum. I've got instructions in here to print them off without wasting paper. And on the first page, I've collated all my favorite shortcuts. And then after that, I've listed every single shortcut that exists in the universe. Okay, so if you want to get access to them, all you got to do is either join the Movie Studio Zen forum, which is a very cool place to ask tricky questions. There's a good community over there. Or just subscribe to the newsletter. If you're wondering, when you subscribe to the forum, that automatically also subscribes you to the newsletter. Hope that makes sense. So let's get cracking. I'm going to use Vegas Pro 13 for this, but everything I'm showing you here with the shortcuts will work almost the same way in Movie Studio Platinum. So first shortcut that I love to use is Control plus O. And I always, for some reason, I just think of Oprah Winfrey, and that's an easy way to remember it. Control O. And so that opens up, you know, your documents folder and you load up a project. Control N, N for Nelly, is if you want to start a new project. So in Vegas Pro, that'll open up the project properties window to get started. In Movie Studio, it'll be a bit different because the new project wizard will crack open instead. Okay, so when you start, after you've started a new project in Vegas Pro, you need to add some tracks. To insert new video tracks, hold the Control button down, plus the Shift key, and then press Q. To add audio tracks, hold the Control button down, just the Control, and then press Q. You can do the same thing in Movie Studio. Movie Studio starts with a few tracks, but they're purely there just to get you going because you're a beginner. As projects get bigger and bigger, your timeline's going to be difficult to see everything. So if you want to see everything really quickly, you can compress the whole timeline. And this keyboard shortcut, you use the Grave Accent button. Now, what the hell is that? So if you look on your keyboard, normally next to 1 in the top left corner, there's this, it looks like a back to front apostrophe. Press that, shrinks everything. To reverse it, to expand everything back out, hold the Control button and press Grave Accent again. That's a pretty cool trick. And probably the best keyboard shortcut that every new person needs to know is S for Split. That's how you cut things up. And instead, when I want to delete something, instead of doing a right-click delete, which is a bit slow, I just click on top and press the delete button on the keyboard. And that, oops, didn't mean to do that. And that way you can fly through deleting quite quickly. And let's expand this out. The old space shuttle. There's J, K, and L. These are universal shortcuts that are used in all programs that play video. Like, so if you press L, that'll start playing the clip. But then if you press it again, it makes the playback go faster and faster and faster. Press K to stop. If you press J, it actually plays backwards. Press K to stop. Another shortcut related to that is the space bar. The space bar plays. But when you press it again, it goes back to the starting point. So that's quite good if you're trying to review something. Another little tip is if you draw out a loop region, to do that, you need to find a blank area of the timeline. Just drag it out. And wherever between those yellow triangles is a loop region. So if you turn on the loop playback and press play, that can be handy if you're trying to work out an effect and you're trying to adjust the dials and you just want to keep it saying repeating over and over again. Another good one is sometimes you need to look at really fine detail in a video clip, and you don't want to be sitting there with the mouse wheel winding and winding. So a quick thing to do is hold control down and press the arrow up. As soon as you do that, it's gone to, if you look here closely, there's tiny little dashes, and that means it's right down to the frame by frame level. So to reverse that, control and down. If you want to go straight to the end of a project, hold control and hit arrow to the right. If you want to go to the beginning of a project, control and left arrow. Somebody on the forum reminded me of this one. Sometimes with these sliders, it's really hard, you know, you've got your finger on the mouse button to get to do small movements. So you can do small movements, but what you do on the, say these sliders here, press on top, hold the control button down, move the wheel on the mouse very slowly, and then the slider will move in its lowest possible increments. Okay, so that gives you really fine control. Control plus C to copy, and then control plus V to paste. But there's also another way in Vegas you can copy, and what you do is you click on top of what you want to copy, hold the control button down, and then just drag. And that's created a carbon copy of the file. Actually, that's what I use quite a lot. Press the letter D and it cycles through the different edit modes. So normal edit mode is normal edit mode. The next mode is a special editing tool for when you're doing envelopes. When you want to do stuff like this and oops, that's not very good. Okay, and then press the letter D again. That gives you the selection edit tool. So you can select certain parts of the timeline and move them around. Press D again. You've got the magnification tool. So with the magnification tool, you drag out an area you want to zoom in on. Okay. And then click again on top. And it goes back, it goes zooms all the way out. Then I'm going to do that control grave accent and we're back to normal. Press D again and we're back to normal edit tool. And the final one I'll mention is F11. So F11 goes full screen, and that's really good when you've got a massive project with tons and tons of different tracks. Okay, that's it. Thanks for watching, thanks for listening, and make sure to check out the next video tomorrow. See ya.